My name is Bryan. I am a father of three, a husband of 20 plus years. I'm retired from the Air Force. I currently work in human resources. Well, my original injury happened in 1997, and I was just walking across a tile floor, and there was some water on the floor, and I just happened to slip. I didn't even fall. I just kind of slipped in the way that you kind of shake yourself. I thought no big deal, and I pressed on with my day, and then about 2 hours later, I ended up hunched over, walking like I was a human question mark. Made my way to the emergency room, and there really began my journey with pain. What they discovered was that I have three herniated discs, L3-4, L4-5, and L5-S1. I started receiving those steroid injections in 2004, and it was pretty much at least once a quarter since 2004 until 2018. So 14 years of worth of injections into my back. Anybody who deals with chronic pain, they'll have some days that are better than others. And depending upon my day, there were days when I couldn't get out of bed. There were days when I could barely function at work, when I would have to remain seated even though my duties, what I needed to do, required me to stand and move and walk and talk to people.
You know, he did get some relief for a while, but then it would just kind of fade away, and he no longer responded to the treatments. Just seeing him in pain, you know, everyone could feel that, and just try to empathize with him as much as we could.
My pain managers over the years had suggested different things, and we had discussed at one point surgery. They gave surgery for me about a 30% chance of being successful. About a 40%, 50% chance of actually getting worse. And I didn't like those odds. So when I learned about the stimulators and the fact that I could try it to see if it worked, that was very appealing to me. And I thought, well, I wouldn't buy a car unless I test drove it, so let's test drive this thing, the stimulator, and see how it works. I did some homework. I needed a device that would allow me to have a full body MRI. And I wanted a device that could adapt to me and my lifestyle. So I chose Medtronic, specifically the Intellis platform. After the beginning of the trial, the very first full day, it was as if a light switch had been turned on. I was able to, for the first time in as long as I could remember, stand up straight immediately after getting out of bed. I was able to stand up for more than 4 or 5 minutes at a time. As a matter of fact, one thing that I really love to do when I am able to is, you know, make breakfast for my children. Well, that first day of the trial, I was able to stand up and make pancakes at the stove instead of having to drag a stool over like I normally had done and sit while I was making the pancakes. Furthermore, I was able to stand up for 4 hours that day without taking a break. And for me, that ability was a life-changing moment. So the trial ended, and I had a conversation with my doctor, explained how emphatic I was and how great I felt because of this. He concurred, and I told him I wanted to move forward as soon as possible for the permanent surgery, and he was able to help me find a surgeon that could actually implant the permanent device, and we moved forward on from there. Having the stimulator has relieved the burden from my mind of constantly having to worry about my pain. I love to cook, and I find myself that I can go into the kitchen and I can bend down and get something out of a drawer or out of a cupboard and it doesn't hurt. I can stand at the stove and it doesn't hurt. I'm able to do the things that I did when I was much, much younger without pain. I'm able to play with my dog. I'm able to play with my children. I was able to, a few weeks ago, play softball again for the first time in 12 years. I'm able to just sit down and read a book without having to move every 5 minutes because I'm in pain. The adaptability of the Intellis stimulator is one of the main reasons that I chose it for me. It has the ability to know if I'm lying down or standing up. And based upon what level of stimulation I need to relieve my pain, it will remember that, and it will automatically know when I'm laying down or when I'm standing up and adjust that stimulation accordingly. Recharging for me is very simple. I put the belt on, I just plug in the recharger to the programmer, and away I go. I can sit down while I do it, I can stand up, I can walk around, I can do whatever I need to do.
Seeing Bryan with his pain under control, it gives me a lot of hope for our future. I know that we'll be able to, you know, experience things that he probably couldn't do before because he was in pain. Our daughter's in college. For us to drive that length of time without him being in pain, it means something that he can get out of the car and enjoy our time there.
Now that my pain is no longer at the forefront of my life, my wife and I and my family, we're able to go out and do those things that we really want to do. We want to go out into nature. We want to go to our state parks, our local parks, our national parks, and I'm able to do those things now. I absolutely notice a difference in everything that my everyday life entails.
A Medtronic implantable neurostimulation system is indicated as an aid in the management of chronic, intractable pain of the trunk and/or limbs. Implantation and use of a neurostimulation system involves risks, including infection, paralysis, lead movement, pain at the implant site, jolting or shocking, and loss of therapy effect. For a list of adverse events that have been associated with the therapy, please refer to important safety information at tamethepain.com/safety-neurostimulation. The medical procedure diathermy cannot be used on someone with an implanted neurostimulation device, as this can result in severe injury or death. Most electrical devices and magnets encountered in a normal day are unlikely to affect the operation of a neurostimulator. However, sources of strong electromagnetic interference, such as MRI and RF microwave ablation, can interact with the neurostimulation system, resulting in serious injury or device damage. Not everyone responds to spinal cord stimulation in the same way, and your experience may vary. To understand the benefits and risks, please discuss them in detail with your doctor. A prescription is required. For complete safety information about spinal cord stimulation for chronic pain, call Medtronic at 800-510-6735 or visit the Medtronic website at tamethepain.com/safety-neurostimulation.